Hello, everybody, and welcome to HNTBAD Orange. And, of course, welcome to my very first entry into this series that I'm going to be calling How Not to Be a Dick. This one's for your Discord users, because why not? I decided I'd start with something that's going to instantly get me in trouble. So the first thing you should know about starting a Discord for your channel is engagement is why you're doing it. If you're going to start a Discord chat and never be there, don't do it. Have a friend set up a fan one. Now, don't sit there and have one that you have to have 18 different stages of verification to talk to you in, because you're just going to drive people away. I mean, I'm going to tell you a story about this one. I joined a Discord server with the honest intention of maybe at some point, like, casually talking to the person who started the server, because I enjoy their content and I like to watch their videos. It's not happening. So I left. I left the Discord server because it's just like, I don't know who these 14 million other assholes are, but I have no intention of engaging with them regularly. And it's I wouldn't have had such an issue with the concept of engaging with them all the time if maybe once in a while, like, the Discord owner had thrown a bone to the people on the Discord. And I get that, you know, these people are busy, especially the bigger ones, the really big YouTubers that have a lot of trouble with, you know, producing content on a daily basis to try and keep up with the YouTube algorithm. I get it. You're a busy person. Don't have a Discord where you're in it. I mean, like, maybe have an account specifically to run that Discord, but even then, like, if you don't intend engaging with the people that came there to engage with you, to be your fan, then don't fucking make the Discord. There's two examples I can think of people that did it right, and this is not a pot shot at anybody, but it's kind of important for me to note. No matter what your feelings may be about Tonka, he engaged with his Discord. He was there all the time. He talked to people in there. And while the dude may not be the most palatable person, kind of abrasive as a human being, he still ran his Discord right. He engaged with the people in that Discord. And he even typed in the regular chat, which, yeah, no, that's important if you're going to have a Discord. The other person who does it right is Dapperton. Mr. Dapperton had a huge problem with his old Discord, so he made the new one, and he has been so much more engaged. He is there all the time. He will, like, talk to you. He'll shoot the shit. He doesn't get in the voice chat, which I know, it's maybe a little bit petty of me to mention, but that's who he is. He's not big on direct, like, instant interaction like that, because, I'm not really either. I try, but I'm bad at it. But the point of it is he is there. He's not just like a placeholder account that sits there and stares at you from the top of a huge list of 43,000 moderators who are basically gatekeepers to talk to this person. If I want to talk to your mods, I'll talk to your mods. If I want to talk to you, I don't want to have to go through 40 other people's approval processes to do so. Number two, doxing. This has become a huge issue with Discord servers for some fucking reason. I will never understand why. I don't get the appeal of it. But there are servers that will occasionally release personal information. And it is very much a concept of the people that are there. Like, these Discord servers aren't made with the intention of doxing. They just kind of end up that way. They just have people who are assholes come in and start doxing. And occasionally, sometimes that asshole is the person that made the Discord or the head of it. A good example of that would be Kraut. No offense there to anybody who might like him, but yeah, no, the dude had the doxing server, and that's our most prominent example we have for that. So never allow that kind of shit. You see somebody doing it, ban them. They'll come back 28 fucking times. Ban them anyway. Do it again and again and again and again and again. Never trust a doxer. Rule number three. Very simple one, this one. don't let shitty people just hang around. Like, if you have a genuine problem with somebody in a Discord server, just talk to the owner of the Discord server. There's a good chance they might not be aware. There's a good chance that they just don't want you there. And in that situation, yeah, no, sometimes you just gotta leave. A good example of that is, again, with Tonka's server. I don't do a lot of drama. I'm not super connected to anything. So because it's not really my audience. I left the server. It's got nothing to do with them. It has nothing to do with watching his show or anything like that. It's just I lost interest. And there's nothing wrong with leaving a Discord server. Let me point out the fact that I am in way too goddamn many of those right now. I'm in too many Discord servers, too many people I don't actually genuinely talk to on a regular basis. And it's nothing against the owner of the Discord. It's just always fucking chaos. And, like, some of the people that I do genuinely want to talk to, like, they're busy. So, I might leave a lot of Discord servers here soon. I'm not really sure, but I am getting to the point where I don't know why I'm in a lot of them, because I don't ever talk to the people that run them anymore. Kind of drifted away. So never feel ashamed for leaving a Discord server. Like, people are going to. And I doubt that anybody who has a level head is going to sit there and really complain about it. Now, rule number 4. And this is the important one. This is what I decided to make this video on. If you're in a Discord server that isn't yours, realize you have no fucking power there. It doesn't matter how good a friend you are with the owner. It doesn't matter how many other mods you find that are willing to support your uprising. Let me be very quaint and blunt and to the point about this. You're not in control there. I get you may have a moral issue with whatever the owner of the Discord's doing. Leave the Discord. I get you may have a legitimate grievance that the owner doesn't seem to want to deal with. Leave the server. If enough people leave a server, hopefully the server owner will give a shit about why people are leaving. But a lot of the times, it's just not the server for you. A good example for that is my server. Heck, even Tranime's server. Like, there are occasionally issues in these kinds of places where, like, a bunch of people won't agree. And the whole thing of it is I'm not the owner of my server. It's for the channel. That's why I'm not the owner of the server, is because I'm rarely ever in there. It's for the channel. We do take suggestions in the Discord, and occasionally I will pop in there and talk to people, but it's not my bag. It's not my bag of dicks. But that said, Discord is an experience that you're going to have to sit there and start to understand. You can't just sit there and be like, ooh, look at me. I've got a pretty party hat on. Nobody gives a shit about your party hat. The server owner does not give a shit about your party hat. You have to leave. Or you have to engage. That goes for both the owner and the people who join it just as fans or friends. If you're not engaging with the server, it's going to die. That's why I've seen so many Discord servers die. It's because there's zero engagement in them. And a lot of the times, that's because 4,800 people join a damn server to talk to the dude that runs the server, but doesn't give a shit about the rest of it. Like, the whole situation is, engagement is important. Especially for the person who runs the server, and especially for the people in the server. But if you're just going around and trolling people, That's the worst part of Discord, trolling. You go in there wanting to have a decent conversation, and all you can hear is, "Gusters," or, "Oh, look at me, I'm such an edgelord." I don't give a shit how much of an edgelord you are. I am too old for this shit. Chill your cockles. Anyway. My name's Ichabod. I have raccoon shit to do. If you like this video, feel free to comment in the bottom of something else that I should do for the Don't Be a Dick series. Alright, I'll see you guys next time.